So when we talk about screening patients for taking care of patients with what we call bowel symptoms, diarrhea, pain, change of bowels, there are ways to evaluate this. It doesn't have to always be done with an invasive procedure such as a colonoscope. It could also be done with an x-ray. There's a technique that's called virtual colonoscopy. Shouldn't be called colonoscopy because one is not looking with a light, but one is looking with an x-ray, and that allows us to see the lining of the colon. The virtuality means that it's being done as the patient is there, on site, on target, in an active fashion, where the physician, usually, for the most part, a radiologist, is looking at the colon, the whole lining of the colon, dynamically, as some contrast, which is something that allows him or her, could be a him or her radiologist, to outline the surface of the colon and then take x-rays of the whole colon, which is quite a large organ. It measures 5 feet or longer. It has a lot of curves to it. So the virtual, without having to put a tube into the colon and then push it throughout the whole length of the colon, allows the radiologist with a contrast, a liquid that they introduce through a very small little tube in the opening of the rectum called the anus, and then take pictures. It doesn't cause that much discomfort. There can be a little discomfort when air is put in. There's no need for the patient to receive intravenous sedation, drugs to fight pain or prevent pain, I should say. This technique is therefore non-invasive, hardly any side effects. It allows the physician to evaluate the whole length of the colon, see if there's something causing a change of the lining or of the opening. We call it the lumen, if it's narrow or not. Similar to colonoscopy, one can see the whole colon. But the negatives are is that if the colon is not well prepared, that means the cleansing that is given to the patient, which is similar to the one that is used for colonoscopy, is not excellent, does not achieve a perfect clean out, then there are changes that can be noticed that may be artifacts, stool that sits on the lining of the colon, and then the radiologist, contrary to a specialist like myself, a gastroenterologist, is unable to go to that site, so-called touch it with the instrument or probe, and move it around or remove it. So what happens is that reports come back to us, the treating physician, gastroenterologist, or internist, or surgeon who requests the study, saying, we don't see anything large, but we see something on the surface and all the way around, the right side of the colon. It may be stool, but it could be a polyp. And the confidence of this technique is 95%, so we could miss polyps that are small, under a half a centimeter, 5 millimeters, that means less than a half an inch. Therefore, we suggest you do another one. Clean the patient better, or if not, do a colonoscopy. So there you can start seeing there's an issue about virtual colonoscopy whereby you still have to clean out the patient. It's not inexpensive. Yes, it's not truly invasive, but you may not be able with certainty to fully evaluate the lining of the colon. There are artifacts that are called, and beyond that, no therapy, no treatment can be offered to the patient. So if there's a polyp there, it could have been removed. On the contrary, if a colonoscopy would have been done, then if there's a polyp, you remove it, everything is done, no need to repeat any more studies, and ultimately it may be less costly and definitely more effective. But there are some patients where virtual colonoscopy is truly advantageous in those who have a narrowing, or there are patients in whom colonoscopy was not totally successful for many reasons, technical, patient discomfort, and so on, and the whole colon could not be fully evaluated. So there is where virtual colonoscopy plays an important role as an adjunct, as an extra study that allows us to finalize the complete evaluation of our patient.